I'm 21 years old. Can I go for a hair transplant? I'm 21 years old with almost a rim of hair left. So what are the options for me? Can I go for a hair transplant?
Thank you for your question. At 21 years old, you have experienced a significant amount of hair loss, and you're asking if you should go for a hair transplant. Well, there's a long history in the hair transplant specialty where it was actually discouraged for many people who were in their 20s who were losing hair aggressively to have a hair transplant. And the thinking was that if you are losing hair so fast that even a transplanted hair result may not be satisfactory when you look at your contemporaries who have a lot of hair. Basically, it's called the rule of decades. In your 20s, if you're a man, 20% of your contemporaries have hair loss, while 80% have a lot of hair. When you hit your 40s and 50s, it changes. Closer to 50% of your contemporaries have hair loss. And the kind of result or type of appearance becomes a little bit more acceptable to have some degree of hair loss as a societal norm. Now, if you were to come to my practice, I'm going to actually introduce to you a concept that I've been very successful with that is very different. And this concept is called hair regeneration. When you look in the market, in the United States in particular, there are two FDA-approved drugs for hair loss. One is finasteride, which is a pill, and two is minoxidil, which is a solution or a foam. Now, what you're suffering from is called male pattern hair loss, and it's also referred to as male pattern baldness. And it is a progressive loss of hair due to the hair follicle becoming less able to generate a thick hair. So it's called hair thinning. So a hair follicle goes from thicker to thinner progressively. And it's been focused first in the 90s, and which was the basis of the invention or the introduction of finasteride, is that there's a chemical called DHT, or dihydrotestosterone. Now, the dihydrotestosterone can affect genetically susceptible hair follicles to the point where with every growth cycle, you know, hair grows through what's called an anagen, catagen, telogen phase. Anagen is the growth phase, telogen is the sleeping phase. When that hair comes out of telogen and then goes back into anagen, the hair that comes out is smaller and thinner. And it has to do with a part called the dermal papilla. Now, our first focus was on DHT, and that's why finasteride, which reduces DHT, can effectively slow down the progression of male pattern hair loss, also called androgenetic alopecia. But what we have found using another level of treatment, which is based on wound injury and stem cell regeneration, is an injection which combines a material called extracellular matrix and your own blood or a part of the blood called platelet-rich plasma. Now, this happened based on a serendipitous discovery that when the donor area of a hair transplant was closed and this material called extracellular matrix produced by a company called Acell that was applied, then hair in adjacent areas that were thinning got thicker. So interestingly, it was kind of like during a transplant that it was noticed that this happened. So over the past 2 to 2.5 years, I have been working and successfully developing a combination of the what I feel so far is the optimal amount of this material called extracellular matrix, mixing it with your own platelet-rich plasma and doing an injection. Now, this injection appears at the cellular level to protect the hair follicle. In 2011, a group from the University of Pennsylvania was able to show a particular cell called a progenitor cell, which actually originates from the middle part of the hair follicle as being the responsible for the regrowth of new hair. However, they found that in men who were balding, that the progenitor cells were not producing a specific protein, and they were actually diminished. So there are actually a couple of different types of progenitor cells that I think about when I do this treatment. And the other part of this equation that I believe that I'm helping people with is actually in protecting the dermal papilla, or the area where the hair follicle comes from. So as a clinician, I make these observations and I lean on basic science to help me make sense of what we're doing. But in the end, what I have seen is that with this injection and with this protocol I've developed, I'm able to reverse thinning hair in 99% of my male patients and 70% of my female patients. So it was a long explanation, but essentially my approach to you or someone like you would be is to first do the injection. I think that if you want to consider taking Propecia or finasteride, that's perfectly fine. And even though it's a controversial topic at this point in time, we still do prescribe it for people who are willing to take it. But a lot of people come to us from all over the world who don't want to take Propecia. And so we have this injection as a very good alternative and helping people who are not on Propecia. So what I think that I would probably consider doing for you first, before a transplant, would do an injection. We would look at how much of your hair volume responds and returns. I can't restore hair that has thinned to the point where it's gone, but I can restore hair that is thinning. So in general, we have had very good consistency in seeing for most males an improvement at about 6 months, and usually we see the full benefit at about a year to a year and a half. And so although some of our patients have had dramatic improvement in as early as 10 days, 21 days, 90 days, it's more consistent that our patients see thickening in the 6 month to 12 month period. So once that happens, for a lot of our younger patients, we then decide at the year point, well, what do you want? Do you want to have more hair to define your frontal hairline? At that point, I would consider doing a transplant, because now I feel more secure about you not losing more hair and not going behind for every step forward. So transplant is an option, but in my recommendation would be first to do an injection like the one I described, and to help you save your hair. It is much better to be able to save hair and thicken it significantly more than it is to just transplant it. You have a limited area of donor hair to transplant, while if all of these fine thinning hairs were to come back, then it would certainly look a lot more dramatic, and you'd get, quote, a lot more benefit than you could with just a transplant alone. Synergistically, the combination of injection and transplant can be ultimately your solution. So I hope that was helpful for you, and thank you for your question.